I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day, and welcome to today's video. Today's video is a combined photo walk and tutorial on photographic composition. So we're walking around Castlefield here in Manchester and we'll be looking at some elements of composition. So for example, the rule of thirds, leading lines, symmetry, those sort of things. I'm going to try and find some examples of those around Castlefield to show you how to shoot those type of pictures. Also, we'll be looking at the technical setup for some of these pictures. Today we've got very high contrast lighting, low sun, deep shadows, so it's going to be a stretch for some of the small sensor cameras to achieve the highlight to such a shadow ratio. So I'll be showing you some tips to try and match the highlight and the shadow within a photograph. Let's get started, let's have a walk around Castlefield and I'll see if I can find some shots which will illustrate some of these points. So this bridge in Castlefield has been the scene for many a television documentary. And it's been used by the set of Coronation Street for one episode, so it's quite a famous bridge. Here I've set up to try and capture the two arches, the one of the footbridge over the basin and the above bridge which carries the tramway and railway line into Manchester Piccadilly. It's really stretching the dynamic range of the camera. So the bridge is the centre point of the picture and I've got that central with the massive column on the left hand side trying to add some balance, and there's a bit of interest with the guy walking across the bridge. So this is the final edit for that image. You can see I've cropped off some of the left hand side image which wasn't adding very much to the overall composition. I've added some extra contrast to the scene to enhance the picture. And you can see the guy coming down the steps on the right hand side is now one of the central features to the image. Again, not quite symmetry, but I got the reflection of the bridge in the water. So we're getting a reflection from the upper surface into the water. Again, the bridge is the central feature, so I've exposed for that. And we're trying to capture the highlights and shadows within this shot as well. So very little change to the overall image, just added some extra contrast to boost up the highlights. Got an extreme example here of leading lines using the two handrails of the bridge to take your eye into the distant part of the image, which is again the arch of the bridge behind it. So again, just exposing for the bridge and trying to pick up some of the highlights in the metalwork. So here again is the final edit, just added extra contrast to the scene. Now in this shot I've tried to use the rule of thirds composition to centre the bridge on one of the intersections of a rule of thirds, vertical and horizontal, so that's the pair on the right hand side of the screen. And we're trying to pick up some of the reflections in the water, so I'm deliberately underexposing by about a third of a stop to try and capture some highlight detail in the river here. Also try to include some of the tree above to act as a natural frame to take your eye into the picture. So we've got the beginning of the canal basin at the base, we've got the trees in the top to act as a natural frame. This is a tricky shot, it's against the light, so it's picking up quite a bit of moisture in the air, so we're getting this blueness to the photograph. You almost see the haze in the air. Using the foreground to act as the lead into the picture, we've got the trees on the right hand side to act as a natural frame to take your eye into the picture, and again some reflections in the water to add a little bit of interest. Once again, the final edit for that image added a little bit more contrast and a little bit more saturation to try and bring some colours into those very desaturated colours that were in the original image. So here is an image that I like. We've got the shadows from the handrail falling onto the footbridge. We've got the leading lines taking your eye into the intersection of the two thirds on the upper left hand side of the image. And there we've got the people standing gazing into the canal, which adds that extra human interest to the picture. So we've almost got an example of symmetry here with the bridge in the middle and the arch following either side, and fortunately there's a tram just going across the bridge. So symmetry is equal on either side of the vertical, so the office block in the middle is the center point, and then the bridge on either side is acting as the symmetrical portion of the image. So once again, my final edit to that image. Again, I've added more contrast to try and add some more structure to the image. Again, a view of that very iconic footbridge over the canal basin, using very strong leading lines from the left hand side of the picture over to the right hand side. And when your eye gets tired on the right hand side, it tends to wander back to the centre of the picture, and there it finds this character walking along the canal basin, which adds that extra interest to this picture. This is quite a tricky shot. It's against the light, but I do like the way the light's falling on that weeping willow tree hanging over the water basin here. Again, I'm trying to use these line of barges to take your eye into the focal point of this picture, which I see as the overhanging willow tree. So all of those elements combine to give you that strong intersection of thirds composition, which really strengthens this image, I think. Again, the final edit, you can see I've added a lot more contrast to this scene and some more saturation to bring up the colours. With against the light shots, you tend to get a lot of desaturation in both contrast and colour, so adding those in post-production brings back the image to how you see it when you take the shot. So here's a scene in the canal basin with that Venetian-like church in the background. I think the composition can be improved. We've got a lot of clutter and a lot that's not adding interest to this picture, so I'm going to zoom in to where I think we should have a better composition. And just reposition the camera. Once again, the final edit of that image, again more contrast, more saturation, just straighten the horizon slightly as it was slightly tilted, and a little bit more sharpening to bring up the detail in that tree and in the distant architecture. So here in this video sequence, I first of all thought I had a good composition with the intersection of thirds on the left hand side of the image, but then I realised if I zoomed in I could get a tighter crop and more interest, but then realised the strength of the composition was really over on the right hand side, so I'm moving the camera over to the left hand side to include more of the left hand bank and allowing the eye to move into the picture from the left over to the right hand side where that barge with the red paint and the tree above it would be the new centre of interest to the picture. Then zoom slightly out to improve that composition. Again, with the final edit for this image, I've added more contrast and more saturation, add a little bit of sharpness to it as well. And you can also notice that I've cloned out that blue polythene container that was floating in the canal there. It didn't add any interest to the picture and I just removed it. As the day progressed, the sun started to become a lot more hazy, and I found this view looking down from the top of Castlefield back into the basin, and just like the way the barge on the right hand side and the banking on the left hand side act as a natural line into the picture to take you into the scene, picked up by those autumnal colours of the trees, it just needed more saturation and more contrast, and that's how I finished with the final image. Using the rule of thirds again to take your eye to this cantilever bridge, using the edge of the canal basin to take your eye over to the left hand side of the image where the eye rests at that cantilever bridge. Again, as with the previous images, I've added more saturation and more contrast to bring out the detail in the image. Here the use of some vegetation in the foreground to take your eye into the picture, and a bit of interest as this canal boat comes into the basin. It's a terminal here, so you can't go very far, you can only turn around. And again the final scene with more contrast and more saturation just to add interest. Again, a very strong use of leading lines to take you into the top one third of the picture, which is the intersection of two of the rules of thirds, to give you this strong compositional element. Quite a difficult shot, again in shadow, and quite a lot of highlights on the building behind, and a little bit of water vapour in the air is adding to the haze in the background. in post-production, you notice I've just warmed up this scene as it was looking a little bit cold, so added some yellow to bring the warmth back. Here in the shot, I like the way the light is falling on the tree in the background there, the autumn colours reflecting in the water, so I'm deliberately underexposing just a slight amount to try and capture some of those highlight details. I know we're going to lose some of the shadow detail, but at least I'm going to capture the highlight detail. Again, the final image with a lot more saturation and contrast added to it. Again, leading lines taking your eyes into the picture, taking you to the central point of interest, which is the archway at the back with the cars passing over the bridge. Again, with this image, I just raised the colour temperature a little bit. Here, because of the wide angle view, we're losing the vertical perspective. It appears to be leaning in from both sides. That's because the camera's not vertical with the subject. If I tilt the camera down, obviously we'll lose the top of the besom tower, but you'll see that the vertical will start to go parallel. This image I've picked out, this lady in red on the left hand side, again roughly on the intersection of the rule of thirds. Again, it's a long telephoto shot looking into the basin, bit of a clutter in the foreground, but I think it adds to the impact of the picture, gives you that feeling of depth. And here on the final edit I've zoomed in even more to emphasize that lady sat on the bench on the rule of thirds intersections. Here we've got the suspension bridge over the basin and a bit of foreground interest in the way of colour to take your eye into the picture. Again, a little bit of extra saturation and a little bit of sharpening applied to the image. And that's the same shot without that foreground interest, just taking your eye into the picture using the edge of the canal as the leading line to the picture. Again, extra contrast, extra saturation, and that's picked out the vertical reflection of the bridge, giving you a vertical symmetry. Now here's a typical image that you might take walking around the canal. It looks like it's going to be a good picture. You've got leading lines, you've got overhanging trees for the framing of the picture, you've got a central element of interest. But that element can be strengthened by moving the converging lines to one of the intersections of the rule of thirds. So I move the camera across to the right hand side to give you a stronger compositional element. So now the leading line takes you into one of the intersections of the rule of thirds, which I think is a much stronger composition than one centred. Now this picture has perfect symmetry both left and right and up and down. The use of reflections and water to complete that vertical symmetry. For the final edit, I've straightened the horizon as it was slightly crooked, and again increased saturation and contrast to bring out the details in the image. With this final video sequence, I think the suspension bridge frames the picture. It's just lacking that element that's required to give it sense of scale, and that would be a person walking across the bridge. And I waited a few minutes for this guy to appear and walked across the bridge, giving that sense of scale. Now here's just a selection of images I shot while I was doing the photo walk. Give you an idea of what Castlefield looks like and some of the scenes you can expect to find if you take a trip down to the Manchester Castlefield Basin. Thank you. it for this short video of the Castlefield Basin, showing you some photographic composition rules and some hints and tips on taking pictures in different lighting situations. If you're a new viewer to the channel, please do click the subscribe button and you'll be notified in your subscription list when I upload new videos to this series. Also, check out the three videos prior to this to show you how to get better image quality from your FZ300 330 camera. Also, check out my photographic blog, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below, where there's lots of more information on the Panasonic Lumix bridge cameras and DSLR photography in general. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye for now.